just want to know what's happening.
Thank you so much for that.
Exactly.
I don't think we'd ever own a home without water features and ponds. I just, yeah, Charlie, I really don't. Yeah, I didn't think that I was going to, I really didn't think I was going to like the vase.
Nope. In fact, I said five or six times,
yeah,
I said, let's not put that vase in.
And Charlie put the vase in, and I went, oh my God, that's beautiful. And I know this sounds strange, but in the wintertime, it's really pretty.
It is. It's really pretty.
Yeah, it starts pulling up ice and it glows.
In the
bowls are awesome.
The bowls are super.
We had them at the other house, you know?
We ordered
and I like that.
Just so that we could come out and sit in the wintertime out here because it's so beautiful. Yeah. It starts to freeze over. It's very beautiful.
Mm. You know, the waterfall is just awesome. I mean, because it's not just eyesight. It's listening, mm-hmm. You know? Like I say, it's like marriage, you know?
There's a lot of legend, which makes it perfect to be able to get in and walk around. So I really love the legend, and I love how you lit it up, because at night it's so dramatic and so beautiful.
Yeah, at night it's almost prettier than it is in the day, you know?
It's like having two ponds, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, really and truly.
But this little area right here is
this,
really perfect.
Yeah, this little pond here.
Because the kids got in and then they could play and I could keep track of both of them at the same time. And it's deep enough that they felt like they were swimming and shallow enough that I knew they weren't.
What do we do? We're engineers by trade.
But our love is to go over to Cambodia and work with the orphanages there.
Yeah, we've traveled around the world in different spots, trying to help wherever people need help. And it doesn't matter where that may be. In the last probably 15 years, it's been Cambodia. Cambodia has been a tough time for us because the needs are so great there. One of the things that we do every 2 years, we probably send 125 to 150 bunk beds to get the children off the ground, the orphans off the ground. These are not, these are true orphans. They don't have a mom, they don't have a dad. Their parents have either died to landmines or to AIDS. Started an organization called NHO, New Hope for Orphans. And we partner with them to try to bring them and try to supply them with the beds and everything they need. They're raising cows, goats, chickens, everything they can to feed the children.
Basically, that they had were beds because some of the kids were sleeping on the floor and some of them sleeping outside in the dirt, in the ground. And the beds that they had were in such bad shape that a lot of the kids had gotten hurt. They fell, the beds fell apart, they had broken bones. Mm. And so our daughter came to us one year and said, we really need to do something.
Yeah, our kids were sleeping in these like little princess beds, you know, Mickey Mouse stuff, Minnie Mouse stuff. And
we take for granted the basic need of a bed and, you know, what it's like to have just that one space that belongs to you and that's your own, where you're protected from the, you know, the things in the ground.
But 10 of the orphanages that time did not have clean water.
They had wells,
but just shallow wells, and it wasn't fresh water. It wasn't good water. And so the kids were...
They had skin conditions, teeth problems.
Really, how do I explain to you that because of what we take for granted, they just going to get a glass of water, they couldn't do. But when they started feeding the kids the water, in 6 months, we went back. And we said, okay, let's go back in 6 months. We're going to check on these kids.
Skin conditions had cleared up. Their hair was growing.
Incredible.
They didn't have as much problems with their teeth. Right?
I mean, it was unbelievable. The water was so good. Now, I would never do this at any other orphanage. I walked over to the little spigot because it runs through the filter system and all that. And I poured water into the cup. I don't even drink water out of my home in Thailand, okay? I mean, the city water is just not that good. So here I poured it in there, and Cheryl's going, really going to drink that? I said, if the kids drink it, I can drink it, you know? And so I drank the water. It was fine.
Nothing happened in a few hours.
No sickness, nothing that I can say on tape. You know, nothing. I mean, the water was pure, yes, you know, but the problem is we don't have enough, okay? But we're trying, okay? And that's what we all ought to be guilty of doing, okay? Yes. Trying. Yes. Not perfect people, imperfect people working a perfect plan, you know? God's plan, not our plan.
Yeah. Oh, so. Perfect.
Thank love you, buddy.
Love you, buddy. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Aww, thank you.
Always. And this is probably a story that will never make the video. It's okay. But little Julius, my grandson, his grandma caught him a little frog. It's a little bitty frog. And so he was holding it and loving it. I love this frog. This is the best frog in the world. And I was worried that he would keep holding it and the little frog needed to be let go. So I told little Julius, I said, hey, go over to the pond and set him free. You know, throw him in the water, set him free. And so he goes, okay, Grandpa, I'll do that. And so he walked over and he grabbed my hand. He had the other frog. He says, you know, I love this frog, Grandpa. I said, I know you do, buddy. Let's set him free. And he says, okay, Grandpa. He throws him up in the air. The frog hits the water. It makes two swims. And one of the fish go, bleep.
No way.
Yeah. And so he goes, oh, Grandpa, I think I'm going to be so sad.
The fish gobbled it down.
I said, well, the frog is with Jesus now. That's okay.